What is up, guys? Welcome back to Patho and Chill. If you recall, last video we talked about chicken pox. Well, today we're going to be talking about shingles, the reactivation of the varicella zoster virus, the same one that causes chicken pox. Let's get started. So for this video, we're going to do it in the story format, just like it did the COVID-19 symptom progression video a couple weeks ago, in which we basically go through the story of a specific person, and as we move on, we progress through the symptoms. So quickly before we get started, I just want to remind you guys that the varicella zoster virus belongs to the family of the herpes viruses, meaning that this one, just like the herpes simplex virus, can be reactivated. So this is also reactivated by various triggers, such as medications, UV light, old age is basically the biggest trigger. Additional factors are stress or any type of malignancies. The tumor could potentially reactivate this virus as well. However, the main difference between the varicella zoster virus compared to the herpes simplex virus is that the varicella zoster virus can only be reactivated once, meaning shingles can only happen once in your lifetime, while with the herpes labialis version of herpes, or the herpes simplex virus, that can happen multiple times throughout your life. So the one we're gonna be talking about today, shingles, can only happen once in your life. Okay, so for today's story, we're gonna have Zach and Cody, two identical twins that both had chicken pox whenever they were little. And you know, these two kids, they love to go to the beach, they love to tan out there, you know. And so what happens as they grow older, trigger plus the UV light from the sun, well, what happens, it re-triggers that varicella zoster virus in both of them. Now here's the catch. One of them, being Zach, he had actually gotten the shingles vaccine. Meanwhile, Cody, whenever he was a couple years ago, you know, he was like, no, I don't really want that. I don't think it's gonna make that big of a difference. It was a really expensive vaccine. So he said, no, I'm not getting it. So one of them had the vaccine, the other one didn't. However, whenever this trigger came, both of them had the reactivation of the virus. So this can happen. The vaccine is supposed to prevent it, but it doesn't guarantee 100% prevention of the reactivation of the virus. However, it does minimize the symptoms that come along with the disease. Okay, so what exactly happens? This disease comes in three stages, right? So this first stage is what is known as the prodromal stage. And so this goes back to all those prodromal symptoms that we've talked about before. So when the virus got reactivated in both Zach and Cody, they both experienced what is known as malaise. We've talked about that before. Your body starts to feel broken down. You start to feel slightly sick. They both experienced slight headaches and both had a fever. So these are just a few examples of these prodromal symptoms. So this prodromal stage, which is the first stage, tends to happen in about 90% of patients that get the reactivation of this virus. So therefore, both Zach and Cody experience these prodromal symptoms for about 1 to 4 days. So near that fifth day, both Zach and Cody started noticing a bit of a rash. Now this rash was only in one side of their body, meaning it was unilateral. And this rash occurred both in parts of their face and in parts of their body. Where exactly can this rash occur? Well, remember, whenever you acquire the virus, it resides in the neurons. So whatever neuron it was residing in is exactly where it's gonna get reactivated. And this tends to normally be in the trigeminal nerve. So remember, that trigeminal nerve has three branches, right? The ophthalmic, the maxillary, and the mandibular branch. So it actually tends to be most commonly reactivated in the ophthalmic branch. So most patients tend to see this linear rash with blisters that can be ulcerated, that then crust very much like chicken pox. They tend to have that near the ocular region of the face. So what are the possible complications of this? Well, if this rash does reach anywhere near the eye, it can actually lead to blindness. So, you know, that is just one of the complications. Doesn't mean it's gonna happen every time. So let's go back to the fact that Zach had actually gotten the vaccine for shingles while Cody hadn't. Well, because of this, the rash that Zach got was very mild. It was not very itchy. Meanwhile, the rash that Cody got was a lot itchier. So here we can start to see the importance of getting vaccinated. Additionally, from this rash appearing anywhere near the face or your body, you can also get ulcerations in your oral mucosa. And this can happen anywhere in the oral mucosa. Okay, so that concludes the second phase of shingles. So remember, we had the prodromal phase is number one, the acute phase, that is where the rashes start to come, and then we have that chronic phase. So this chronic phase usually only happens in about 15% of people. Cody, he should have been vaccinated because he somehow happened to fall in that 15% that actually get the chronic phase. Well, this is actually called postherpetic neuralgia. So what exactly is this? Remember, we've been talking about how this virus resides in one of your nerves. Well, as the symptoms progress, the nerve actually continues to get damaged from the virus being in there and basically sensitizes itself to where any touch near the area of where the virus actually resides just sends sharp shooting pain down your body, down your face, especially in the location where the virus actually resides. So oftentimes that is in the face. Now this pain can last for 1 to 3 months, but there have been cases in which it goes to even a year of your life. While Zach was, you know, chilling on the beach, you know, he had a little bit of a rash that wasn't too itchy. Cody was over here dying, you know, scratching it. So he had to receive skin ointments and antivirals to minimize the symptoms. So this is actually something that you can use as a treatment. So basically, moral of the disease, if you're not vaccinated, then you better hurry and go get vaccinated because I don't want you experiencing this postherpetic neuralgia that we've talked about. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure you smash the likes, hit the subscribe button, and peace out.